Okay, a very good evening, everyone, and I hope you all are doing well. I, Dr. Sarika Chauhan, advisor, WI Affinity Group, IEEE VSIT student branch, welcome you all to our event, Mandala Art Workshop, organized by WI Affinity Group of IEEE VSIT SB to offer a chance of wisdom to fight against these tough situations and for your well-being. Before starting the workshop, I would like to give a gentle reminder to all the participants to keep their mic on mute mode throughout the session and make sure to enter the session with their full name. Make sure you are carrying a A4 size white sheet, a black pen, compass, pencil and eraser for the workshop. We will be sharing the feedback form. See, we will be sending a mail which will contain the feedback form link. Once you will fill up that feedback form, you will be receiving a mail containing your certificate. So don't forget, after the workshop, don't forget to check your mail related with your feedback, and then you will be receiving the certificate. Don't forget that only after filling up that feedback form. So we request you to submit your feedback. I'm sure everyone is very much excited and eager for this workshop to begin. So it is with great pleasure that I introduce today's guest, Ms. Pooja Lalwani, to all of you. She is an economics and maths faculty at HR College of Commerce and Economics from the last 6 years. She has also written several research papers, one of which is accepted for the publications in IIM Ahmedabad. Apart from being an exemplary professor, Ms. Pooja Lalwani is also a mandala art practitioner, a self-taught mandala artist, which is a therapeutic and meditative art form. She has not only taken more than 15 art workshops in lockdown, but also trained around 200 artists. So all while conducting regular workshops for Madcap workshops and scholars tour. The mandala art holds symbolic and meditative meanings beyond their vibrant appearance. And it is a symbol of deeper connection with the self and the universe at large. Now, without a further ado, I request Pooja ma'am to begin today's Mandala Art Workshop. Over to you, Pooja ma'am, and welcome once again.
Thank you so much, Dr. Sarika. Thank you for the introduction. Thank you for having me today. I hope everyone enjoys the session, and I hope you all feel calm and at peace at the end of the session. So thank you so much. Ma'am, I hope you're also doing it.
Yeah, my daughter, she is doing it. She really loves
this drawing. Oh, wow. Yeah,
and
all that. I know.
Yes. So she is doing it. She's sitting just next to me.
Oh, great. Okay. So should I begin?
Yeah. Please start.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. So I'll just turn my camera to the sheet. I hope my sheet is visible to everyone. So I want everyone to take an A4 size sheet first and just divide your sheet into 4 equal parts. What I'm trying to say, get me an exact half of your page vertically and horizontally so that we get the center of the page. So ideally an A4 size sheet will be 21 centimeters by 30 centimeters. So you can take 10.5 centimeters on top and draw a line with a pencil. And 15 centimeters from here and draw a line to get the center. If everyone can see, I have marked my center. So this is the center of the page. Now the beauty of a mandala is that it looks beautiful. At the same time, it's supposed to be really therapeutic. So, I mean, even when you look at it or when you're doing it, it increases concentration. So if you can see, I mean, you know, just looking at it itself will like make you feel at peace. So everyone just get the center of the page. Mandala is all about symmetry. So if you realize, like all these petals over here, they're all symmetrical. So it's all about symmetry. I hope everyone has a black pen because that's the most essential thing today. A ruler, a pencil, preferably an eraser in case we go wrong anywhere, and a compass. These are the things I want everyone to remove and keep. And just get the center of your page. I would also request everyone to just pin my video so you can see only my video on the screen. Ma'am, is my sheet visible?
Yes, ma'am, it is visible.
Okay. Once everyone's got the center of the sheet, I will just start. So, yeah. Okay, now there are certain measurements that I'll give. You don't have to follow those measurements. If you go, like, in case I say 1 centimeter and it's 1.2, it's okay. It's not about measurements, but yes, within a grid, there should be symmetry. Within a mandala, there should be symmetry, but the measurements are not that important. It's just that if you look, want your mandala to look like this, then you just follow the measurements I'm giving. If you realize, even if one of these measurements, like let's say this one, is slightly more, it'll still look pretty. So, yeah. Now, once we get the center of the page, I want everyone to take 0.7 centimeters on their compass. So I am using a pen directly, but I would suggest for the first time, put a pencil inside your compass and then you can go over with a black pen. So I'm just measuring 0.7 centimeters. Yeah, this is 0.7. We just take it on our sheet, on the center of the sheet. And draw a circle. So if you realize, it's all about circles. There'll be a lot of circles in a mandala. And the best way of doing it is going on turning your paper.
Ma'am, can you repeat?
Take 0.7 centimeters on your compass and just draw the first circle. Just 0.7 centimeters on your compass. So we've got the center of the page. After getting the center of the page, we are drawing a circle. That's the first step. Yeah, that's my first circle. And preferably do it with a pencil first and go over with a black pen. Initially, whatever mandalas I used to do it with a pencil and then go over with a black pen. So if your compass does not fit a pen inside, it's okay. You can even do it freehand because when you do so many layers, it's not the perfection of the circle is not going to show. Now I want a thin border outside this. So if you've taken 0.7, take 1 centimeter. To give a thin border outside this first circle. Just to give a thin border. So I just gave a border to my first circle. And if you realize that border, we are just going to simply color. So it's this color that we've done, it's that. After this, I want everyone to take 2 centimeters on their compass. We're done with 1 centimeter. Now the next one is 2. Take 2 centimeters on your compass. I'll measure the, repeat the measurements again at the end. So that's the next circle, which is your 0.2 centimeter circle. We have 0.7, we have 1, and we have 2 centimeters. These are the three circles we have done till now. So remember one thing in a mandala, your circles should not be exactly equidistant. So if you have one circle which is 1 centimeter, the other one should not necessarily be 2, and the third one 3, and then 4. It's ideal if you have variations. Like when you have thin circles in the middle, it looks good. It just ends up. If you realize here I have one thin circle which I've simply just colored black. After 2 centimeters, want everyone to take 3.5 centimeters. The next stage is 3.5 centimeters. I'm just going on writing the measurement so that no one is confused. So we took 0.7, then 1, then 2, and then 3.5. After 3.5, we will take 4.5 centimeters. Sorry, 4 centimeters. And after 4, 5.5. I'll again repeat these. This is my last circle. Rather, second last, we need a border to this. After 5.5, you can take 5.7. That's it. Anyone has one more color pen, nothing like it. If you do not have, it's okay. Like I have this purple. So if you have one more color, then we can add color to the mandala. If you do not have a pen, any other color pen, it's fine. We can go ahead only with the black one. So this is our main circle for our mandala. We are done with this. We have to start the designing. I will be having one more circle, but the reason I didn't draw it is because I don't want to do that in a pen. I want to do that in a pencil. Now at the center, this is always called the core of the mandala. Now when you even look at it, any core of a mandala, when you look at it, you will just feel relaxed. It's just natural. So it's supposed to be the center point or the focus or the center of focus rather. So it helps you concentrate when you're looking at it. Ideally, mandalas are done with soft, soothing music around. So it just helps you heal. Now, this is my center. What I am doing, I am drawing something like an exclamation mark. This is the way I'm doing it. At the corner. So that's an exclamation mark. Now I want you to color the rest of it black. So if you have a thick black pen, nothing like it. If you don't, you can do it with your original pen. You just have to color this entire thing black. If your sheet is thin and you're using a book, please keep some other sheet below it. So I am doing that. Because otherwise I'll spoil my original one. First thing we do is give it a border and just color it. If anyone has any questions, you all can unmute yourselves and ask. I have no issues. If anyone wants me to repeat anything, please unmute yourself and tell me. I'm just giving this a border and just coloring it, simply coloring it with black. If you have a sketch pen, nothing like it. Yeah, I hope everyone's got this. That's it. That's our first step. After this, now mandala is all about petals. Like you will have a lot of round petals or pointed petals at each layer. So if you realize even over here I have these petals, then I have petals over here. Then again over here we have petals. These are round petals. So it's all about petals. So my first layer, this one. So I'm going to leave this thin layer out because obviously it's giving a border to the black that I have at the center. And after this, we have our round petals. So my next layer will be round petals. Try and be as symmetrical as you can. In case you have a protractor at home, you can always place it and mark 10 degrees so that you have exact grids and you are symmetrical. If not, you can just... The more you do it, you will automatically become, if you all can see the design, this is how I'm doing it. So these are round petals. So these are my round petals. Now, the balanced part of these round petals. I'm very sorry. The balanced part of these round petals. The white part. I'm done coloring my balance part black. Now inside these, we are going to give a border. Yeah. So inside each of these petals, if you have another color, you can color these inside the border, you can color with that color. So you realize over here, I've done. So this layer is done. If you have another color, please color inside of this with that color. If not, you leave it like this only. Very nice. Now for the next layer, we need to do pointed petals. That's the essence of a mandala. I'm going to first do it in pencil. Don't you realize there is no symmetry? I'm really interested in this art form, please use a protractor because then you'll get exact symmetry. Like you're going to use it every time, you're going to draw it every time. Yeah, so these are my petals. I'm going to draw it with a pen so that you all can see it.
Pooja ma'am, I think you are mute. Pooja ma'am, can you just unmute yourself?
Yeah. You can hear me? Okay.
Yeah, yes.
Everyone follow up till here. So I've just done petals. And now inside each of these, from the center, we are doing petals.
Is it clearly visible to everyone?
Yeah, can everyone see it? Should I hold my phone closer?
Ma'am, no, it is not clearly visible.
Visible, it's a little blurry.
Okay, 1 minute. I'll just. Change my camera angle. Yeah, is it visible now?
Yeah, it's
okay.
It's so very close though. It's very close. Now?
Is it fine, ma'am?
Yeah, it's perfect.
Okay. Everyone's clear till here? You all want me to repeat any design? No, ma'am, it's clear. Perfect. Okay. So inside each of these petals, I am just doing petals. So the technique of doing this is, I will show it in this one.
from the center of the petal. So if this is the center of your petal, if you realize this is the center, go upwards and just do a petal like this. Now both the sides, we have to just touch the corners. From the center, touch the corner, turn back and come. From the center, touch the corner, come back and like this. Again on this side, from the center, we touch the corner and come back. So this is how we do it. And this is the essence, actually, mainly mandalas have a lot of such petals. So I'm just showing it closer so that you realize how to do it. So inside these, we have to do a design. I was just showing the technique of doing this. Now inside this, we just have to do the alphabet I in small case. But so if you see, I've done the alphabet I. And again on this side. So we're just doing the alphabet I, and the balance white part we will color with black. So this is how it is done. Again over here, we are going to do an I inside each of these and color the balance white part black. I'm repeating it in this one. So from the center, we go upwards, turn back. We go on touching the border of our petal. And then again this side. And inside we do I. And we color the balance part. So the white area inside each, like if you see even in the first one, we colored the white area black. It's better not to leave a lot of white area in a mandala. It is time consuming, but it's really therapeutic, like I said earlier. So, and once you concentrate and do it, you don't want to do anything else. So that's the reason why it's a form of meditation, because you will not think about anything else when you're doing this. It needs that much focus. Again, from the center, even if you are observing and you're going to do it later, I hope you send me pictures. Yeah. Again, we cover the white area. So we have to do this throughout all the petals. If anyone wants me to repeat anything, please tell me. Till your head. Like whoever's doing it real time, have you all got it? Now we have these three petals left. So the ideal way of doing it is you finish all these petals inside, because your hand is trained to do it. So like finish one, then finish the next. Someone has raised their hand. You want to ask something?
Yes. Yes. Please tell me the distance which is taken in the in between two rounds.
Yeah, I'll tell you. So the first, this one you want to know all the circles?
Yes. Yes.
All. Okay. So I started with 0.7 centimeters. After 0.7, so this was my 0.7 centimeter circle. Then I had 1 centimeter.
Okay.
After 1, I had 2 centimeters. So this one was 2 centimeters. And after 2, I have 3.5. So this one is 3.5 centimeters.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Welcome. The ideal way of doing it is just finishing off the petals. So, you know, you're done with one design first, then you do the eyes inside, and then you do the coloring inside. So, like I said, our brains are just trained to do the same thing. So, you know, you just go faster when you're doing the same thing over and over again. And in case you feel you're getting bored, then you can probably finish one entire petal first. So, I finished all my petals. Now, inside, I'm going to do eye inside each. Yeah. Now, I'm going to color the white part of each. When you are coloring anything black in a mandala, it's called negative space. And when you are leaving a lot of white, it's called positive space. Having more of negative space in a mandala is better because it just, if you realize in this, I have a lot of negative space. There's very little white left in the middle except for this part. So it just ends up looking good. Now, because it's the first time, I'm sure a lot of you will be doing mandalas, I've cut short few layers from here. So now inside this, if you realize we have a lot of white space left, which I don't want, like I'm not going to move on to the next layer because I don't want so much of white space. So what we're going to do inside, it's a very simple thing. Just I'm bringing it close so that you can see what I'm doing. I'm giving this a border. And we're going to color this. Simply color it black. If you have a thick pen, please do it with a thick pen. Okay, so I give it a border. Then I'll give it another border. Like this. And we're going to do this throughout. So in each of these, it's very simple. We are just giving it a border. So give this a border. And just simply color it black. So I'm not repeating it for the entire layer because I'm sure it's very easy and everyone would have gotten it. If you have another color, if you realize over here, I have given, after this border, I have done a border with a golden or an outline with a golden rather. So if you have another color, you can do that. Anyone wants me to show with another color, I will. Or how to use any other color in this, I will. So please let me know. Like this and like this. Yeah, this is how it will be. Ma'am, should I repeat the entire thing or is it okay if I just show these two? Okay, I hope everyone's okay with these two. If anyone wants me to repeat this design, please let me know. Okay, now the next layer. Very simply, we have to just color it black. Can you see? I've just colored this black. So this layer, the layer we have after this, we just have to color this black. So what I'm going to do, or if you have any other color pen and you want to use that pen to color, you can definitely do that. So in case anyone wants to know how to use another color, I will just show you. So inside the first petals that you had, you could just see, if you can see, I colored it purple. So these petals that we had left white, you could color it purple. Then instead of doing these eyes, you could just give it purple strokes. And over here, you can give a purple border. Like this, just a border. So in case anyone wants to use any other color pen, this is how you can use it. If you want a dual color mandala. Okay, the layer after this, I told you, you just have to simply color black. So I am not getting into that because you just have to use your pen and color it black. So I'm just putting process out here. Although at the end, before I end, I'll just color it and show you as well. Now the next layer, and that's a very interesting design. So please have a look. I'm bringing my phone really close. So you have this line in the center, right? You can start from there. So I've done a quarter circle. Colored that black. Done these lines. This is called a Bombay design. Given these lines inside. Then another layer. Again, colored that black. And one last layer. I'm given these lines. Now what you'll do, you'll change the direction. Now you will start from the bottom. So a quarter circle. Color is black. Then again, a parallel line. These lines. Then again, we have this. Again, one more layer. And these lines. So what we're doing a quarter circle, coloring it black, another layer, doing lines inside, another layer, coloring it black, another layer. And you're going on changing the directions. This one. I'm visible, right? Can someone just tell me if my screen is visible, if y'all are getting it? Any one person?
Yes, ma'am, visible.
Thank you so much. Okay. Okay. Now again, I'm going to change the direction to top. So I'll do a quarter circle, color this black.
Screen is not visible, ma'am.
Now?
Yes.
Okay. Now another layer. Then another layer, coloring it black. This is actually called the Bombay design. It becomes repetitive after a point, but it'll look very good. I'll just show you all how it looks in actual. So see, this is how it looks. I've colored it golden in the middle, wherever I've done those lines. Because I have used golden throughout my mandala. So if you're using any other color, these lines you can just color with that color. Then again, one more line and lines in the middle. Then again, I'm changing the direction. Coloring this black. We're going to do this throughout the circle. So obviously you should do it at your own pace. Take your time to do it. Another layer, color it black, another layer, and we have these lines. Okay, now similarly, again, you'll go on top, again, bottom, and you'll do this throughout your circle. Okay. Now, after this, the next layer, we are going to leave it blank. Okay. And we are doing one more layer, but this layer, because it was with a pencil, I did not do the circle first. That's our last layer. So if you realize till now, it'll look very pretty when you do the entire thing. I'll just tell you all the measurement. The last measurement we took was 5.5. From the center, let me just get my center. On your ruler, just measure 6 centimeters. But this time, do not do it with a pen. I don't want you to outline with a pen also. Just a minute. I know y'all won't be able to see my screen. I'm just measuring how much I want. Okay, y'all can take around 6.3 centimeters. Because we don't want a very thin one also. So I'm just drawing a circle at 6.3 centimeters with a pencil. We are going to do round petals again. You all remember the round petals we did at the beginning? So we'll do round petals again over here. But the design inside the round petals will be different. Okay, so throughout we'll do these round petals. Now please see the design. It's a very unique design. It will make it look 3D, like the outer layer will look 3D. Divide it in half. I'm doing something like an inverted V inside. Now the top part of it, color it black, top left, and the bottom right. When you do this throughout, like I'll do another one as well. So do a inverted V inside, top left. And bottom right. Okay. Again, next layer, divide it in half. Something like a pointed petal inside. Top left, color it black. And bottom right. So I don't know if you realize, but it's supposed to look 3D at the end of it. Again, divided in half, pointed petal inside. I'm just showing it very close. Top left, and bottom right. So we'll do that throughout the circle. So it just looks very nice. Divided in half. So you can see my screen, right, everyone? Did you all get the designs? Now I'll just go on completing it. Anyone has any questions, please ask me, because I'm done with showing you all the entire design. Now I'm just completing it. So anyone wants me to repeat any of these or do anything, or if anyone's done and wants to show it to me, please do so. If you all have any other questions related to a mandala also, you all can ask. So now I'll go back to my, so that was my entire design. I am just going back to it and completing it. In case anyone wants to unmute themselves and ask, please do so.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, mandalas are only in circle shape or it can be in any other?
So mandalas actually are in a lot of different shapes. So I will just show you. Like if you realize over here, I've done a moon. So you can do a moon, like this is a 3D one, but again, this is circular. But there are various shapes, like there is a morpang that I have taught and done before. Like see, this is a phoenix. So again, there is a mandala inside this. But yeah, this is again circular inside a phoenix, but it doesn't have to be circular. So obviously, the essence of a mandala is a circular one. That's the main essence of a mandala. But you can have various other designs. Like over here, I've done a morpang. So I've done mandala designs only inside these. But yeah, again, there is a circle. So generally, there will be a circle involved in a mandala somewhere or the other. So that's how it is. But I just showed you the different forms that you can still have. You can even have a semicircle if not a circle. So that you can have something like I have done this one. So there's mandala inside the lotus. So that's how it is. Anyone has any other doubt about any design or anything about mandala, please ask me. Or should I just continue doing it? I can even do that, whatever you all want. Sarika ma'am or Seema ma'am, are you all there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, should I continue just doing this or anyone wants to ask questions? Has everyone got the design or should I just go on?
Yeah, if anybody has any doubt or any question, they can unmute themselves and ask.
Ma'am, did your daughter get it? Should I repeat anything?
I think no one has any doubt. Yeah, yeah, it is doing. So other, you can continue, ma'am. Then.
Okay, okay, I'll just continue. I'm not giving this a border.
Ma'am, which is the pen that you're using?
I'm using a Brustro fine liner, but you can also use a Staedtler pen. So, Staedtler and Brustro are the best ones for mandalas. And if you really do a lot of mandalas, then you can use a Micron. So, but Staedtler is the one which is readily available in the market. So, you know, I'll just show you the Staedtler one. Yeah, so this one, you must have seen this quite often, the Staedtler pen. So these are the ones that I use sometimes, or sometimes I use the Brustro one. Both have the same effect.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome.
Ma'am, actually, which colors you prefer in mandala?
So I generally, I'll be very honest with you, black and white are the main type of mandala. So I love black and white mandalas, but I do add little color to my mandalas. Like if you notice over here, I just added obviously green and blue because it's a morpang. Then in the lotus, I added pink because again, it was a lotus. But ideally mandalas are supposed to be black and white. So when I do a black and white one, I'm more like, I don't know, I'm more satisfied than when I'm doing any colored one. So yeah, ideal would be black and white.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome. If anyone likes doing mandalas, you can just follow me on Instagram or drop me a message. I keep holding a lot of workshops with different designs, especially my 3D one and all. You can just drop me a message.
Will you give us the more information about the mandala, how it is helpful?
So how it is helpful, the main thing is actually it was started in ancient times. If you realize, like, you know, when you're meditating, you're not supposed to get distracted with other thoughts or something like that. And when we are doing a mandala, ideally we keep looking at it, we keep concentrating, you're engrossed in it. It's more about symmetry and, you know, these circular patterns, which just automatically calms down your mind. Because, you know, when you're looking at circular patterns, you will think you're getting hypnotized, but more than getting hypnotized, you just feel at peace. You forget everything else because your focus is on this. So this is what I realized when I kept doing mandalas, that I started itching to do mandalas after a point. So they're supposed to be an ancient art form. It in fact started off with Hindu temples way back then. Even in Jainism and Buddhism, there is a lot of significance of mandalas. That's why there are a lot of Buddha mandalas, which I have also done. So that's how it started off. So in a lot of temples, you will see a lot of mandalas around. In fact, for that matter, there is this Japanese 7-star restaurant, which is based completely on the concept of a mandala. So, you know, you'll not realize it, but in a lot of decorative items and all, they actually use it. But it's actually widely used, which no one has realized. And it is a form of meditation also, which no one knows about. So even in meditation, there are different forms, right? There would be yoga, there will be sound meditation. So mandala is actually a form of therapy or meditation or healing. So anyone dealing with any issues wants to get distracted. In fact, I held one workshop for an NGO in the middle, wherein there were a lot of people who were either orphans or like homeless or whatever. And yeah, there were some autistic ones and they really enjoyed doing it. Like, that was that 1 hour when they were happy. So it has a lot of healing benefits. So you may not even realize it, but it just heals you. So that's how it is. Like, that's how mandalas are supposed to be. So the more you do it, the more you get engrossed in it. You know, you'll start thinking of different patterns you want to do. You'll start building your own patterns. That's what I started doing. So, like, at the end of a stressful day, you will feel, oh, I have to sit and draw. It is going to be so stressful. But actually, it's the opposite. So, and you don't have to be good with a pen or you don't have to be good with drawing to do a mandala. That's what I realized, because I was actually not good at drawing before I started doing all this. So, but you will see.
Thank you so
wonderful
much.
Ones.
We are right. Really enjoying.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much. I'm glad you are. I hope everyone else also is. Like, if you realize, this one will turn out beautiful. I'm just going on doing it, because if anyone's done it and wants to show me, y'all can do that as well. Like, generally in workshops, you know, everyone just keeps showing and then I'll just tell them where to go, right? Or if you want to do it later and show me also, you can. Anyone has any other doubt or query? Ma'am, should I stop out here? Because now the design is repetitive, so like, unless anyone wants me to repeat any design.
Can you please tell us more about benefits of this or anything more information about mandala?
So more benefits of this, again, like I said, apart from healing, it increases concentration. So a lot of children should do it. because like if you want to learn, so I have a lot of clients which are only 10 years old and 9 years old and who've been doing mandalas, such mandalas, not even like, you know, like big ones, proper intricate ones. So, and their parents are making them do it because it just helps in increasing concentration. So when you do this, like obviously instead of having a lot of screen time, so because nowadays there are a lot of people who are obviously online classes, whether we as teachers are taking or children are glued on to the screens because of online classes and they don't have an option. So this paper and pen, I mean, you will feel that it is actually again stressful, but it is not. It will actually help in healing your eyes. So I don't know if you're aware of Drishti. It's a yoga pose. Okay, so not a pose, but a yoga exercise when you're just supposed to concentrate at the tip of your pen, and it really helps. And that's the same thing that happens with a mandala, because you have to concentrate at the tip of your pen. There is no other option. So it's very good for children, because if they're concentrating, it will help in their, I mean, you know, their eyes will be relaxed, in fact. So they say doing a mandala is as good as keeping a wet towel on your eye. So that's how it is.
So, that's, so have you learned it from somewhere, ma'am? Or are you a self-taught this mandala artist?
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you. What did you say?
Have you learned it, or are you a self-taught mandala artist?
No, I've not learned it. I am a self-taught artist, so okay. I did not learn it.
Great. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank Welcome. You. Anyone wants to ask anything else? If you want, I can send this entire design, my original one. So if anyone wants to practice it, or I can even send few designs that I do. Y'all can even, if I have any videos also, I do have a few videos. I can send it if anyone wants to just watch that and practice and not even like, you know, sit and do it at one time. Y'all can do that. I can send it to you. Or y'all can just see my Insta handle there. Also, there are a lot of videos put up. So you can just follow that and do it.
So if you can just share your Insta handle so the people may follow you.
Yeah, I'll do that. It's okay. I don't think this has a chat box. Is there a chat box over here? Or I've not used Teams before.
No problem. Maybe you can write it on the piece of paper which you are ready to write it.
Yeah.
Chat box is disabled. That's
where do I write it?
You can just share with us. Even we are sending them the mail, so we will share.
Share it with you.
Yes. Okay, ma'am. Okay. And even the video links, if you, I think it's there on your Insta, no issue. So I'll share that your Insta account with the participants. Participants, perfect. If you have any question or anything you would like to share, you can unmute yourself. And I would really like to see if you are done with this thing. So you can just switch on your video and you can show your design if you are done.
Yeah, if anyone's done, even if anyone's done a little bit of it and you all can show nothing like it. I mean, yeah. I would love to see.
And we'll be sharing this video also, or like the today's recording on our IEEE YouTube channel. So anyone from the participants, yes, we'll be sharing everything with you. All of you, participants, it's a voluntary thing, but we would really love to see your design. If you can Suchita Petnekar, yeah. You can unmute yourself and ask. Yes, Sita?
Yes, ma'am. I want to show.
Yeah, please show.
Really great. Yeah, show.
Okay, someone else has also raised their hand. You all can just switch on your video and show.
Yeah, you switch on your video and just show. This is Pooja, right? I think Pooja, ma'am, you have to switch off your video. You're done, no, ma'am?
You are done, no, with your design?
Yeah, I'm done.
Yeah, so if you can just switch off your video so others can just show.
Yes.
Others, those who wanted to show, no, this just switch on your video and you can show your design.
Hello, ma'am. It's visible.
No.
Ma'am, it's visible to me.
Yes. Now it's visible.
Yes, it's visible.
Okay, I still can't see it. I'm really sorry. Let me just try. Who's showing? Suchita?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, just pin Suchita so you will be able to see his.
Yeah, I just did that.
Who else wants to show? So they can just raise their hand.
Hello, ma'am. Any visible, ma'am? Hello?
No, not yet. I don't know why I can't see it. Just a sec. I'll just check. No, my internet connection is fine.
Ma'am, can you see this? Ma'am, can you see this design? Is it okay?
Yes, I don't know why, but I can't see anyone's designs. I don't know whether it's a setting of theme.
No, we can see.
Okay, 1 minute, ma'am. Let me try. Yeah, now I can see. I had to turn on incoming video. Pallavi, wow. It's amazing. I really love it. Like, it's exactly perfect. So, Chita, now even you can show again because now I'll be able to see. It's really nice. It's looking very nice.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
It's perfect. So, Chita, you can show again.
Yes, ma'am. Why not? Ma'am, it's visible. Is it okay, ma'am?
1 minute. I can still see Pallavi. Yeah, perfect. Perfect. Wow, it's very pretty. It's very nice. Exactly. It's very nice. I really love it. Exactly perfect.
Good job. Yeah. Muskan, want to show?
Hello, ma'am. Hello.
Yeah. Anyone? Oh, wow. Anisha, I really like it. I mean, it's very nice.
Visible? Yeah.
Anisha, it's very nice.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, perfect. Really nice. Yes.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
I really like the way you all have done it. So I hope everyone else also does it. Ma'am, you can just share their pictures if they do, if everyone finishes it whenever they do. So yeah, I hope you all enjoyed. If anyone wants to do more intricate designs, just you all can even message me. I'll help you out. There's no issue.
Yes, anyone else? Muskan, you can lower your hand if you're done. Or if you want to.
Is anyone else showing?
Come on, others. Even if it's a half done or whatever, you can just show. Okay, I think everyone has done. Anybody else wants to show?
Yeah, I think we are done. Yes. I think everyone will do it.
I'm showing, you can't see it.
Who's that? Oh, Supriya. It's very pretty. It's very nice. Okay. It's done as a pencil, right? As of now?
Yeah.
But it's perfect. It's really perfect.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm waiting for you to finish it. Very pretty. It's really nice. Like, I like it more than, it's more precise than mine, to be very honest. So, yeah. I think everyone, whoever had done has shown. So on my page, I can even share it with ma'am. I have a sheet of basic mandala designs. Like, you know, in each petal, what all variations you can do. I'll share it with ma'am. Ma'am, you can just share it with the ones who are, like, you know, really interested in it. And they can go ahead and make their own designs from it.
Yeah, sure.
Perfect. Okay, ma'am. Are we done?
Yeah, anything else from the participants' side? Okay.
So I would just request Khushi to present a vote of thanks. Khushi, are you there?
Hello, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes. Am I audible?
Yeah, you are.
Good evening, everyone. I, Khushi Sharma, Chair, WIE Affinity Group, IEEE VSIT Student Branch, would like to thank Ms. Pooja Lalwani for guiding us and helping us to know more about the symbolic mandala art. Your workshop helped us promote mindfulness, focus attention, and promote healing and inspire everyone to try this art form for their well-being. Once again, I would like to thank ma'am for your time and contribution for this workshop. We are very fortunate to have this wholehearted support of VSIT, Dr. Rohini Kelkar, Vice Principal of VSIT, and Dr. Asif Rampurawala. Mr. Asif Rampurawala, I'm very sorry. And the management of Vidyalanka Dhyanpi Trust in all our endeavors. I feel honored to express our immense gratitude towards them. Before we conclude our session, I have a few requests for the participants. You will receive emails, including feedback form, which will be sent to registered attendees. So please ensure that you submit it by today, so you will receive your e-certificates. Planning and smoothly executing the event wouldn't have been possible without the collective effort of our team of very dedicated and result-oriented individuals. I cannot thank everyone enough for their involvement they showed right from the beginning. I would also like to thank everyone for their and very much in making the whole program a success. To you, we owe the greatest depth of gratitude. It was a great pleasure to have you attend the event. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Sarika ma'am and Thima ma'am.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Pooja ma'am. And just an announcement to all the participants. You again, that's kind of a reminder. You will be getting one mail with the feedback link and the recording and whatever Pooja ma'am is also sharing, video links and her Insta account. So just a request to everyone, as soon as you fill up the feedback form, you will be getting the mail with your certificates of today's event. So thank you everyone from our side, and thank you so much Pooja ma'am once again.
Thank you ma'am, thank you so much.